big one. First, I would like to thank John Chua for making this gathering possible. When we started in a very simple idea of a just paying for a visit and knowing this condition, and I greatly admire John for his incredible drive and power to inspire so many photographers and his concern for all of us. So that's why we're all here now, and I'm happy remain. Let's all give a big hand to John Chua. That person I greatly admire and respect. I've been with the Agence France Press for 32 years now. I joined the company when it has not established any photographic office in Asia. And during that time, in 1985, my company only presence was in Europe, with its headquarters in France. And the biggest competitor at the time was AP, UPI, the United Press International, Associated Press. So those were the two big top agencies when AFP decided to launch the International News Picture Service. So the competition is very tough, and competing with more senior photographers like AP photographer, I think that was Andy Hernandez, and UPI, where you have William Bigoy, Sayang, I'd like to see Ali, which is the son of William. And during that period where I think we're lucky to be around during a period of political turmoil in the 80s, where it started with a martial period in the 70s, and later years of Marcos, the assassination, and the massive ongoing protests. I think these are political events na nakapagpanday ng dedication ng pagkaseryoso naming mga photographer ng generation namin, na everyday maraming nangyayari. I can see then suddenly, and then that's where I started seeing John out of his studio from Ad Photo, and we were shooting demonstrations almost every day together from Ayala, from Benjola, from maraming mga ibang lugar. So talagang sa araw-araw, talagang you have all these mga events na wala ko pahinga. And I think that was something had driven us. And for being a UP student at the time, of course, who were mostly in the front lines of all these activities of protest, and given that developing our social concern, which was our driving force. And I look at myself as a photographer. Ano ba yung pwede kong gawin para makatulong? Ano ba ang role na being a photographer? I mean, we take pictures, and for whose pleasure, di ba? And during that time, I begin to dawn on me na maraming malaking paraan na itutulong ang photography para to propagate the truth, to see things the way as it happens, to deliver the news, the five W's that we have known before: what, when, where, why, how, and niya sa photography class.
Ito yung malaking bagay na naramdaman ko. Every time I take pictures, and ano pa yun eh? It's all film camera, 36 shots. Na in one assignment, meron ka lang pati mga estudyante kami. Bibili lang kami ng mga film na reloaded na 100 feet. Na dahil, ano ba yan? 5 pesos, 6 pesos yata, no? Sabi ko yung reload film.
Per roll,
yun, 36 shots. No? Oo, minsan may sobra, wait, 40 shots, bonus. So imagine yung ganung klaseng discipline na you have 36 shots to tell a story of important political events na kung ubus na yung film mo, nakatunghanga ka na lang, diba? You have nothing else to do. So tipid na tipid, no? Kailangan mo habang may nagra-rally, hindi mo alam kung kailan nila tapos yung rally, nagbabakbakan, no? Oh, 20 shots na. Oh, 30 shots, 5 shots na. Hinintay ka na lang ng pinaka-event. Ubus na, nangyari. Oh, patay na. At least, may nakasave pang isa doon sa posible may mangyari. So ganun, I think that kind of discipline na malaking bagay na nakatulong sa amin na being decisive. Hindi ko tuloy ngayon, meron ka na you can shoot as alibi ko eh. Dumating ka rin. Oh, ito, nabanggit ko si tatay mo. Oh, nakompetensya ko nung araw. Oh. So, ganitong klaseng discipline na malaking bagay. I think it's still the same idea na you have to develop for you young photographers na want to sama na kayo mag-shoot, eh. Diba? Di, compared to, ha? Unlimited rice. So with a 32 gigabytes, yes, sige. Now, yung transition from film slowly to digital, so, yes ka na ng litrato, no? When dati madaling mag-edit kasi pagka-shoot mo, develop yung film, it's a chemical, you know, black and white, it's a fixer, so you spend at least mga 6 minutes developing time, washing, fixing time, 5 minutes, so at least mga 11 minutes to 12 minutes para katapos ka ng developing pa lang yun. To turn the film into negative, it's a dark room. And then, pag negative na, na-dry na, printing na. So, with an 8x10 of paper, i-print mo yun, pipiliin mo yung negative mo, tarinig siya, editing. So, what? Kasi, it's a 3 best shots. Ganun, ka-repeat, no? Or 2 best shots. Kasi yung 2 best shots na yun, yun yung kailangan mong may print and may transmit immediately. So, ganun yung condition. Sa newspapers naman, ganun din, tipiran din, diba? Hindi pwedeng makapag-submit ka ng 10 litrato, yung pang front page, pang importante, at least yung 2 best shots. No? Mabilisan na. All manually processed, printing, shooting, developing, and printing. So, matagal, Albert Garcia, mabuhay ka. Dumating ka rin. So, ganun yung mga nabutan natin ni Albert yung mga panahon na yun. So, pakonti-unti, developing technology, dumating na yung digital, malaking advantage ngayon, malaking pressure. Napansin ko na with the digital, there's so much pressure with the photographers, journalists like us. Now, we have to deliver real-time. Patay na. So, kaya nakikita ko ngayon, lahat ng mga photographer hands pa rin sa newspaper, at least nagkakaroon ng multiple role. No? Photographer, mag-video, mag-feed pa ng report. No? So, sabay-sabay ito. Kaya, yung focus ng photographer ngayon is either hindi na 100% shooting pictures, but depending doon sa nature ng company na kailangan mo mag-deliver ng video, magsushoot ka na skill, magsushoot ka na video. So, There's multiple multitasking. I think that's the trend now of the technology. But then I think the essence of what I will always come back is driving principle. I take pictures not for my personal pleasure, but I take pictures to educate others as a photographer. And it takes a lot of discipline to build yourself, your confidence. Sabi nga ni John, you have to give 110% of your best. Which, napansin ko lang, yung mga panahon na mga ibang nakasabay ko, at least there's also what I, being a fine arts student, malaking bagay din na nakatulong doon sa pagtingin ko doon sa around what's happening, you know? Because photography, there are conditions, you are surrounded by pictures 360 degrees. Di ba? Ang isang rally ka, alin ka, may nangyayari sa likod, sa harap, sa kaliwa, sa kanan. And where to point your cameras. So it's your visual analysis of what is, where is the situation that is the most telling. And it takes an eye to see that, you know? And the eye to see takes years to develop. Kaya yung mga bata nag-aral ng journalism, I think it's a very good background. But then for the others who wala namang background in photography, like, that's why I respect Willie Lipoy so much, no? His humble beginning, if I may say, he started as an office boy sa UPI. Tigilinis ng opisina. Slowly, may mga photographer na dumadating doon, nag-observe si Willie, naging interesado siya, and mula doon sa paglinis sa opisina, naglinis ng darkroom, nakita niya yung mga what the photographers are doing in the darkroom, naging interesado siya, hanggang natuto siyang tinuhol siya mag-develop ng film. Wala siya nang totally, doesn't have any schooling of photography or anything. But then, magaling naman yung mga photographer na who works for UPI then, when they see somebody na interesado, oh, ito, really, no? Itong camera, itong film, gamitin mo yan, practice ka na. Then, that's how he started picking up. Kaya, there are several ways of approaching a situation where gusto mo maging photographer but you don't have that background. I think it's all about the driving force. It's all about being creative. It's all about trying. It's all about making mistakes. It's all about learning. Ito lang naman, yung mga simpleng rules that John has already presented to us. It's on the commercial side, I think that's a strength of John, but then I have so much respect for him other than the commercial side, na he was able to give something the, for himself and to become a journalist as well. I think it's a very delicate balance when the two schools of photojournalism and commercial photography are in direct conflict with each other. So it's when in commercial photography you're endorsing a product, and then when you're photojournalism you need to have a critical perspective. You cannot endorse anything, but you can only endorse truth, objectivity, and fairness. So I think ilang muna yung question ko siyo sa inyo, and I think for most of you have known and followed my career. I have been to Afghanistan 3 times. I have been to Iraq, the first Gulf War and the second Gulf War in 1999, 2003. I was embedded during the 2003 Iraq invasion, 40 days in the U.S. Army 3rd Infantry Division, from the first day of the
offensive, it's a white border crossing by land to Iraq, and Baghdad was captured. So at least that was one assignment when it was offered to me. So me and Romy, you did the first World War. We wanted to be part of the team again. And the condition is once you're in, this time you cannot get out. Meaning, this time as embedded photojournalist, you have to start where you will be permanently assigned in a military unit that will be your fixed position, and you will be photographing all the events that are happening within that particular unit. And from the first day to the last day, until you have accomplished the mission, and nobody knows how many days for them to accomplish the mission. Yung nangyari ngayon, and then nangyari sa atin sa all this war and conflict, nangyari ngayon sa Marawi sa atin, and some of you have been to Marawi. I think mga ilang photographers, I think the Rolex, ay di ba, si Francis, si Mark. Yun. Now, ito yung pinaka-seryosong conflict that happened in our country. No? Of course, during the time of the MLF period, the Muslim insurgency, the communist insurgency, these are scattering mga locations na guerrilla style conflict. But then, itong Marawi was something more or less urban conflict na naging more conventional. But it takes a lot of approaches to dealing with this kind of covering the conflict. So the conflict that we have witnessed that happened in Iraq, in Afghanistan, suddenly, and ito sa Philippines. And thank God that patapos na yan. And then the best part, na through the 5 months na nangyari itong lahat ng mga photographer, lahat ng mga journalist, lahat ng mga cameraman, full covered, the Marawi conflict. Salamat sa Diyos, alam na disgrasya, alam na matay, alam na sugatan. I think that was the greatest achievement. Almost one Australian journalist, maswerte pa rin siya, tumahan ng bala. Hindi inabot sa spinal column, so it was just a slight injury. And I think this is something, a good record in any conflict situation. At least you're a journalist sent there, and the best, what is not being said to you is you have to survive your mission. And you guys are being careful in a situation where you're facing danger. In a degree of miscalculation, is you cross the fine line between life and death. And yun yung, from my experience as a journalist, I'm covering that I have always created a plan A and plan B. The plan A scenario is things that will happen normally, and the worst case scenario. So I have to be prepared with the worst case scenario, anything from coming under fire, anything from getting ambushed, the convoy, getting caught in a crossfire, and what to do in that kind of moment, situation, na alam mo yung gagawin mo, where to go, where to follow, who to watch, the soldiers, where they go, if you come under fire. And then, if the plan B, the worst case scenario, didn't happen, at least everything goes well. The worst enemy in this kind of situation is panic. When you're caught in a crisis situation, suddenly it's a split-second decision that would make a matter between your safety and your risk. And when you're in panic situation, you cannot make a clear judgment. And that's where accidents happen. I think this kind of approach I can share to you,
you can also apply that in any situation, not only corporate, but always a plan A and plan B. Siguro, malaking bagay na maturo sa inyo, but being a journalist is one thing special. Otherwise, sipong presentation niya lang and finalize. So, anyway, marami pa tayong mga line of speakers. And we have sponsors, Camera House, and this is one of the best parts. We have people and companies from Camera House, like Paul Fuji, who are here to interact with us. Ito yung mga moments na hinahanap natin na are here and malaking bagay. And patuloy na yung sabi ko natin dyan when I was starting, wala freelance pa ako noon, ay pinapasalamatan ko si Sunny Camarillo dahil doon sa Sun Photo Supply, I can go to his shop. Sunny, ang ganda itong 18mm, gusto kong bilhin ito. Oh, sige, installment na yan. Nabayaran ko every month, may installment ko, hanggang pa konti-konti, no? So, yun,